I'm Mad Scientist, it's Miss Sarah here, and I'm outside the library with my kite. I'm gonna show you guys how to make this today, along with Ruff Ruffman. He's gonna help out and show us how to make this kite and how to take advantage of this beautiful weather and some of the wind that's out here.
In your kit this week, you will find a guide from Ruff Ruffman. You will find a piece of string, a couple pieces of map that I have cut down, a dowel rod, and some tape. So the first thing you're gonna do is take one of your pieces of map and fold it in half. We're gonna have it so the long ways is going to fold over, kind of making it look like a book. Next, we are going to measure and mark 1 inch on the top and then 3 inches on the bottom. So we are going to fold it over at an angle. So we connect that part from 1 inch to the 3 inch. And you're gonna do that on both sides, just like this. See, it's already looking kind of like an airplane. Just like that. Look, those are its wings that'll flap. Now, we are going to take some of that tape that you have and tape the top part. This will keep the two sides together, make it kind of flat. You can use as much tape as you want, trying to make it just go right along that center part, and that will hold it together. Now you can make a tail for your kite by cutting a piece of some of that other map and maybe accordion folding it over and under, however you want to make a little tail, and tape that on as well. Now it's time to take our dowel rod. This is going to give our kite some structure. So we're gonna tape it along the wide edge of your kite and use a bunch of pieces of tape, however many it tapes, to hold it in place nicely. All right, now I'm gonna flip my kite over. I'm gonna take a nice sharp pencil and mark a spot towards the top of the kite where I'm gonna poke a hole through. You can do this with your sharp pencil or you can use a hole punch if you have one. And we're gonna take just the one end of the string, loop it through and tie it in a nice tight knot. You might need your grown-up to help you do this. You wanna leave the long end loose so you can hold on to it when you take it outside like this and watch your kite get caught up in the airflow. You see how it kind of hovers and then it swirls and dives? So if I had a cameraman other than myself, we'd probably get a little better view. But holding onto the kite and the camera didn't work so well. But I hope you have fun playing with your kite. I'll see you next time.